on this session on the US MLE examinations and pathway for PG medicine in the US. So step by step, we will, you know, understand. So let me introduce you to the American healthcare system. So 22.7% of licensed physicians in America are IMGs. So all of you, when you guys will apply for your admission in the US, you are termed as a IMG, International Medical Graduate. Okay. So whenever you find any discussion, any information where the word IMG is mentioned, it's relevant to you. The number of IMGs practicing has grown by nearly 28,000. 98% of IMGs speak two or more languages. Interesting. 62% are in primary care physicians. All right, that's almost double than the US physicians. The share of female IMGs is on rise. 45% of international medical graduates are female physicians. And where do these IMGs practice? Majority practice in the South, that is your Texas, Florida. 28% work in Northeast, that's your Chicago, New York, New Jersey, Philadelphia. 17% in the West and rest in 3% in the military bases. All right, perfect. So now let's move ahead with the important few information. Where do IMGs work after their graduation? So once IMGs complete their PG in America, 33% of IMGs work in a hospital. Okay, that's most popular. Followed by 31% working as a group practice or a, what we call as a polyclinic. And then 20% working as a single or a two-doctored physician, while the balance 10% work in managed care, like an academic or an unclassified setting. 27% of international medical graduates are from India. Now, amongst the international students, you know, IMGs who are working in America, majority are from India, followed by physicians from med schools in Philippines, Pakistan, Syria, Nigeria, China, Lebanon, UK, Germany, Russia, Ukraine, you know. In fact, on the Moksh platform also, we have a lot of physicians from, in fact, 10 different countries. So we're happy to, you know, be global in that sense. Before I move ahead and talk about the current updates of a US residency match. First of all, what do you mean by residency? Residency in simple terms means PG. Okay, in India, we call it PG. In the US, those are called as residency programs. So before I talk about this number, I usually prefer conducting polls. So yes, let me quickly ask you the next poll that again gives me an insight about how aware you are about the procedures. All right. So again, quick request all of you to quickly participate and let me know what according to you is a tuition fee to do post graduation in America per year fees. Okay, not cumulative. So prior to lockdown, my last session was in a government medical college in South India. And in the last 3 to 4 years, I have almost visited 250 plus medical colleges across India, right from government colleges in Jammu or Shimla to down south in Kerala, you know. And believe me, you know, whenever I have asked this question, like 100% of you would say, yes, I know about USMLE. Okay. But the obvious next question, that what is the tuition fee to do post graduation? What, how much do you pay as a tuition fee? Unfortunately, only 50% are aware. Can you see that? Even that is true today. Only 48% know the correct answer, that there is no tuition fee. The rest of them felt, okay, because it is US, it will be 50 lakhs, 35 lakhs, 1 crore. No, you don't pay a tuition fee. Okay. Doing a PG in US is like doing a job. You are on a work visa, which typically is a J1 or an H1B visa. So, A, you don't pay fees, B, you get salary stipend. So, minimum salary stipend is around 45 to 55,000 US dollars annually. Indian rupees is almost 40, 50 lakh rupees. Okay. So that is huge, right? So A, I don't pay tuition fee. B, I am getting paid. You know, so that makes US as a very attractive destination. But you need to keep in mind, it's a job. So admission also has various parameters, which we'll be discussing during our journey. So let's quickly understand what happened in this year's admission cycle. Okay. The 2022 admission cycle was the largest in the NRMP history. What is NRMP? This is the counseling body in the US, right? They decide on finally on the algorithm basis how many people got admission in which specialization. Total 34,266 seats available for PG in America. Okay, and this number increases every year. This year they added 2,000 seats. Can you see this? That's a huge number getting added every year. The number of non-US citizens getting admission is the highest since 1990. So majority of you come into this category, okay? Unless you have a green card, you all are in this category. So this record, a 30-year-old record, was broken. Highest number of people getting admission internationally. So this is actually, you know, something which all of us need to understand. Because whenever, you know, some announcement or some political things happen and people start panicking, you know, and start reacting, but they don't realize certain countries, you know, and the dominance. So certain specializations and certain countries are too dependent on Indians, okay? So which also you need to understand and take into consideration. The rules what you have for a student who is doing engineering might not be the same for medicine. Okay. So this is something which you need to understand. All right. So why am I saying that? Because, you know, anytime any announcements comes and people start believing rumors and spreading rumors. Okay. So first time when Trump came into the power, okay, everybody said that US is over. Nobody will get admission and, you know, stop thinking about USMLE. They wrote off USMLE back in 2016. Can you believe it? What actually happened? What actually happened was exactly the opposite. Every year that Trump was in power, the number of international students getting admission was increasing year on year, with 2020 being highest. In simplified version, if I tell you, when 10 students from international med schools apply to US, 6 get admission. Now, somebody who applies for a medical school for PG in India, when 10 students, MBBS students from India apply for a PG seat in India, only one seat is available. So if you see the shortage of seats in the Indian system, in India 10 is to 1, in America 10 is to 6. So this is something which is very important for all of us to understand and plan things accordingly, right?